Eternal God, our Father, we thank you for this day. We pray, God, that you would move in such a special way. We pray that you would enlighten our women, inspire them, empower them. Let them know that they are your creation. Let them know that they are your joy. They are your gem. They are your center of attraction, oh God. Father, we pray that you will let them know that they are mighty in your hand. Eternal God, we pray that your Holy Spirit may dwell in this place. We pray for the traveling mercies of those who are on their way. We pray, God, that you would allow us to let go and let God on today. For it is in Jesus' mighty name we pray. Let us all say amen.
Amen.
Amen. Amen. Come on and give God a hand clap of praise. Receive our women's choir on today.
Yeah.
Tragedies are a common place. All kind of diseases, people are slipping away. The economy's down, people can't get enough pay. But as for me, all I can say is thank you, Lord, for you are.
always, and you always work hard. Whenever tough times come along, all you do is pray. And then you pray some more, and then you keep on praying. And save the day if you can, as often as you know how. And what better day than this day to let you know how thankful we are to have you. You're an example to be followed, and we love you very much. And I'm going to leave this with you, wishing you all the power of hope, the beauty of love, and most of all, the promise of peace always. God bless you, and God keep you. It's my prayer. Amen.
Thank you so much, Sister Harry, for that wonderful tribute and planting the vision seed for our wall of fame. Seed from the Kia Mom Baker.
For this opportunity. Pastor, thank you. This family. But also, when I got the invitation, I saw Sister Vinay Brooks and Sister Gail Moore on the bottom, and I'm thinking the whole time, I'm like, okay, Vinay Brooks, Gail Moore, I'm like, is this the same people that I know? And I see Sister Jean Moore, they have known me before I knew myself. You know how people say that? They have literally known me before I knew myself, working with my mother at Ivy League school. And so it is just great. I was high-pitched when I came in. It was just, I'm like, it's so exciting. So I mean, it's wonderful to be able to connect family and friends, and then to have Jesus in that connection, and that's going to be wonderful.
Amen.
So glad to be here. My mom and the Striblin is here, and my husband and my daughter, and he's going to take that out of our hands so she can listen to the sermon today. Amen. At 5. Amen. She's going to hear the word today. I'm blessed to be joining ministry with my husband, Reverend Keith Baker, so he is chilling in the congregation today. Amen. Word today, let's go straight to it. The word today, I'm going to pull from Ephesians 1 as Sister, I didn't make sure I say that right. Sister Brooks read this morning. So I'm just going to reread that in the Message version. And I'm reading 11 through 14. It's in Christ that we find out who we are and what we are living for. Long before we first heard of Christ and got our hopes up, he had his eye on us. Had designs on us for glorious living, part of the overall purpose he is working out in everything and everyone. It's in Christ that you, once you heard the truth and believed it, this message of your salvation, found yourselves home free, signed, sealed, and delivered by the Holy Spirit. This signet from God is the first installment on what's coming, a reminder that look at everything God has planned for us, a praising and glorious life. Amen?
Amen.
Amen. So the message today is signed, sealed, and delivered. All right, so we're going to keep that in Jesus, not in Stevie Wonder, but signed, sealed, and delivered. So our Christian walk, as your theme, is all about pursuit. It's all about movement, movement in our prayers, movement in our spirit, our godly expectation, our promotion. As believers, we are constantly about movement. It's akin to Acts 17:28, for in him we live and move and have our being. And it's about gaining an identity in Christ. Who are you? Who are you? As a child of God, a daughter of the King, brothers are not going to leave you out. Don't fall asleep on it just because it's for the women. Who are you? Ladies, sometimes we get consumed with being everything for everyone that we forget our place in Him. And that's a serious note. Because we all wear our capes every day. We waking up early. We're going to bed late. We multitasking, running services and teaching choirs and preaching. There's so much that we are constantly doing. We're working. We're trying to stay in shape. We're trying to look cute. We're trying to make sure the bills are paid. As I tell people, my husband is the mayor, but I am the CFO, comptroller, and treasurer of Bakerville. But he's mayor. But there's so much that we are constantly doing and being a part of, but at times we lose our identity in Christ. Who has Christ created me to be? What am I really supposed to be doing? I know I get caught up in a whirlwind of what people expect for me to do. They see something in me like, oh, she can do it. Sometimes you have to say, hey, that's not my gift. That's not my talent. I got to politely say no to that. Who am I in Christ? Who has he designed for me to be? That's a question that we all have to know. We have to get to know ourselves in him. Christ has given us an inheritance. Now, inheritance usually goes to people that you're related to. Everybody know at some point, I know as a coach, we don't do this very well, but we need to have a will in place. We need to have power attorneys. We got to listen to Susie Orman and other leaders to make sure that we have our affairs in order. A lot of times that we don't. But our inheritance usually goes to people that we are related to. And the good stuff go to people that we like a whole lot. There are those people that you like a whole lot, you get the good stuff. But a lot of times with the good stuff comes a lot of the pain and sorrow. A lot of the argument, a lot of dissension because people don't know who they are in Christ. You know, you get to those times and family and you start figuring out who did what. And somebody got the house and somebody got $500. Real talk. And people still trying to figure out who getting the diamond earrings and who getting the cubic zirconia brooch. And people mad right before the funeral because people trying to figure out who getting what. And this is all I got. I got gospel jewelry. That's all she left me. But Christ has left us a real inheritance as his children. But we need to know who we are in order to receive it. So when he calls our name, we won't be looking around like, you need to know who you are so that he can give it to you. So he can give what he has designed specifically to you. Because if you're not right, he ain't going to give it to you. He's not going to give it to somebody else. Your gift will not go to somebody else. But if you ain't right, I'm going to just even wait till you get back. He is not going to waste his gift. He's not going to waste his talent. What is the good stuff that Christ is ready to give to you? We're all appreciative of the nice house and the promotions, but it's the intangible things that we have to capitalize on. He's given many of us the ability to hold our tongue. Amen. Amen.
Amen. Amen.
This is short time here talking about I'm a Christian, but I cut the devil is a lie. Cut that mess out. Cut that mess out. Yes. I'm a Christian, but I cuss a little. Y'all, don't do it.
Amen.
Don't be weird, don't buy that stuff. He's given us the ability to be able to hold our tongue. He's given us the ability to be able to talk fruitfulness, to be able to empower somebody, to be able to encourage somebody. You have that gift, you have that ability. He's given us the opportunity to hold our peace and let him fight our battles. We ain't always got to mount up. We ain't always got to call the cow as soon as somebody say something. Let me call. You don't have to call somebody. No. Calm down. We be ready. Ready to fight. And I'm talking about believers in that Christian fight. Be ready to lay somebody out. Damn, out in the spirit. Opportunity not just to be happy but to have joy. Yeah. To have joy because happiness depends on the happening. I don't want to be happy just because it's the know and testify about it. But you know, people always say when they get a certain age, even the young people, my generation, I can't wait till I get older and I can say anything that I want to say.
A matriarchal lineage. No, no,
decided personally that I want to be a believer. It's not because your parents were believers that that's not how it works in the kingdom. Even though our parents bring us to church, our children are not saved because of us, they still have to make their own declaration of salvation.
Amen.
But it's because we believe. That's the crux of our faith. 1 Timothy 4:10, that is why we labor and strive, because we have put our hope in the living God, who is the Savior of all people, especially of those who believe. Hebrews 11:6 says, and without faith it is impossible to please God, because anyone who comes to Him must believe that He exists and He rewards those who earnestly seek Him. John 3:18 says, whoever believes in Him is not condemned, but whoever does not believe stands condemned already, because they have not believed in the name of God's one and only Son. John 4:42 said, they said to the woman, we no longer believe just because of what you said. Now we have heard for ourselves. And we know that this man really is the Savior of the world. John 10:38 says, but if I do them, even though you do not believe me, believe the works, that you may know and understand that the Father is in me and I in the Father. Those are Jesus' words. Mm-hmm. They didn't even believe Jesus.
Amen.
He said to them, if you don't even believe in me, at least believe what you see.
Yes.
At least believe the works. Believe. John 14:1 said, don't let your hearts be troubled. You believe in God, believe also in me. No worries, Mom. He said to Thomas, put your finger here, see my hands, reach your hand into my side. Stop doubting and believe. The time has come, Mark says. The kingdom of God has come near. Repent and believe the good news. We're here because our belief, your pursuit of destiny, is because you believe in Christ. You believe in His transforming power. Our redemptive walk is because of our faith. It's because of you said you believe in Him. You accept, you believe, you confess. Our testimony is about Jesus' redemption, His redemptive love, that He decided that we were good enough to die for. And that's when I always love to take a little pause, because you know you best. I'm going to close my eyes on this one. You know you best. You know sometimes how you like to get under people's skin. You know sometimes how you like to say the right words and tick people off.
Well.
You know those places that you volunteer to go. You know those people that you try to get back at. You know those things that you said that you meant to say, and only make like, oh, I didn't really mean it. You meant to say it.
Preach.
You know those things that you plan to talk about. You know those people that you called with the idea to run somebody's name down.
Go on.
Take it. You know the setup that you did. And through all of that, He still decided to die on the cross for you.
Amen.
He still gave His redemptive love for you. He desired to save you from evil, whether that evil was outside or inside. He desired to save you from that, to save us from ourselves sometimes. It's because of our belief that you get what God intends for you. You ever hear, my child actually told me, where she says at school, they were doing snack time, and you get what you get, and you don't get upset. You ever heard that? Yeah. Just be happy with whatever you're going to get. Get what you get and don't get upset. But I'm glad the Lord doesn't treat us like that. He gives us more than that. The end of 14 says, it's a reminder that we'll get everything God has planned for us. What is that? A praising and glorious life. You don't have to struggle. Capitalize, underline, doesn't want you to leave here crying. He doesn't want you upset. He wants you to live a praising and glorious life. And it's not that you got to walk around so sometimes we get a little, you know, super Jesus in us.
All right.
Y'all know, they not here. But you know, the super believers. And everything is Jesus, Jesus, Jesus. I'm with you. Will help somebody. And you don't have to be in church to give your testimony.
Amen.
Somebody asked me, how you doing? And you got 30 seconds and shot right line to minister to somebody.
Yes.
Brothers and my sisters, my hope today is that we stay signed, sealed, and course. He sealed our promise. And we are delivered in him and constantly being delivered. And I love in the Message version where it says in 14, this is the first installment of what's coming. There's so much more. This is just the tip of the iceberg. What I'm experiencing, what I'm living in, what I'm loving on, this is just the first installment. And if I get all this, just with the first installment, can you imagine how the rest of your life is going to be? Amen?
Amen.
Amen. Give God some praise. Amen. From other churches, or there may be some people who did not stand. And there's always some people that ask you, what time does service start? Okay, so I'm gonna try to come about maybe 20, 30 minutes later so I can miss the part where you have to stand. But we want to be able to offer Jesus to you. He is the one with the transforming power. He's the one that you want to make the connection with. And so if you don't have a personal relationship with him, we offer Jesus to you now for him to be your Lord and your Savior. He desires to be your Savior. And he would die on the cross for you. And you would need to make him your Lord. Christ is not a bully. He's not going to make you do anything. But we would want him to be our Lord. So if you again, don't have that personal relationship with Jesus, we offer him to you now. If you don't have a church home, Providence came and welcomed me as soon as I stepped through the door. And so I see that this is good, fertile soil, fertile ground. And I know that they will be glad to have you. And so if you don't have a church home, a place where you can connect with someone that you can say, hey sister, hey brother, and walk out this Christian walk, Providence is available to you for your growth, for your education, for you to be all that you can be in Christ.
Amen. Great.
Amen.
Great.
Amen.
Great.
Amen. Praise God.
Hallelujah.